Hi, I'm Christopher Crockett, and I'm the astronomy writer at Science News. In 2017, we'll be learning about new things in our own solar system, to the center of the galaxy, out to galaxies billions of light years away. One of the things I'm looking forward to in 2017 is astronomers figuring out where fast radio bursts are coming from. These are these really big blasts of radio waves that appear to be coming from other galaxies, but we have no idea what's causing them. Astronomers are getting really close to narrowing down where these things are coming from by detecting them at one telescope and then quickly catching them with another telescope. And I've heard some rumors that there might be some really cool discoveries and announcements coming up pretty soon. A bit closer to home, there's a project called the Event Horizon Telescope that's been running for about a decade. And what they're doing is linking together radio telescopes around the world to create one giant virtual telescope that's about the size of the Earth. And what they're hoping to do is actually see the supermassive black hole that's about 28,000 light years away in the center of the galaxy. And we've never been able to actually see a black hole before because they're black. They don't give off any light. But what they're looking for is actually light that's being bent around it by its immense gravity. It's a phenomenally difficult thing to do. It's like trying to see an orange on the surface of the moon. The Juno mission is at Jupiter, and it's been there since July, but now it's going to really start doing its regular science, mapping the interior of Jupiter, getting a 3D picture of what the biggest planet in our solar system is like on the inside, looking for how much water there is, whether or not there's a core. And that'll tell us a lot about how Jupiter formed, and that can tell us a lot about how the rest of the solar system formed, and solar systems throughout the galaxy. But I think one of the coolest things going on in the solar system this year is the end of the Cassini mission at Saturn. After almost 20 years in space and over a decade at Saturn, the mission's coming to an end. The spacecraft is going to start going where it's never gone before. And it's going to start repeatedly diving between the rings and the planet. As they fly through the rings, they're going to spin the spacecraft so that the big radio dish is facing forward. They're using that as like a deflector shield. And so if anything from the rings hits it, it'll just bounce off the antenna and protect the instruments behind it. So that'll let them get really close to Saturn, see details they've never seen before. They'll actually be able to figure out just how massive the rings are, which might tell them where they came from. And then in September, the mission's going to end by deflecting and diving into the atmosphere, and the spacecraft will plunge to its death, making measurements all the way down. The reason they're ending it that way is actually to protect the icy moons around Saturn, moons that we think have saltwater oceans beneath them. So Cassini may still carry some sort of biological contamination on it, and they don't want to remotely risk our biology getting into the oceans of Saturn's moons. So they're just going to toss the spacecraft away into the planet. It's always a really cool year to be writing about astronomy. We're always discovering new things. And I'm sure 2017 will be no different.